Good day everyone and welcome to today's lecture on solar taxonomy. I'm here to help you understand what solar taxonomy is and how it can benefit you in your academic and professional pursuits. So let's discuss the solar taxonomy. SOLO stands for Structure of Observed Learning Outcome. And solar taxonomy was developed by John Biggs and Kevin Collis in 1982. SOLO जो taxonomy है, ये model education में use होता है और इसका क्या मकसद है कि एक student की level of understanding को assess करना. Simply आप ये सकते हैं कि it's a framework that helps student to assess the level of understanding and knowledge of student in any given topic, yani bacche ki jo understanding hai, level of understanding, usko assess karne ke liye solo taxonomy use kiya jata hai. Agar hum levels ki baat kare to isme total 5 levels hai. Jo simple level hai wo pre-structure hai, yani ki ye lowest level hai, theek hai. Pre-structure jo hai lowest level hai, then uske upar jo hai uni-structure hai, then multi-structure aata hai, then rational, then extended abstract hai jo highest level hai solo taxonomy ka. Lowest jo level hai wo pre-structure hai aur complex jo level hai wo extended abstract hai. Ab inko one by one hum discuss karte hain. First jo level hai wo pre-structure hai. Pre-structure means the student has no knowledge or understanding of the topic. Student ke paas koi knowledge nahi hai, koi understanding nahi hai topic ke hawale se. Ye ho gaya pre-structure level. Second hai aapke paas uni structure jisme student has a basic understanding of one aspect or idea related to the topic. Means ki student ko jo hai just basic understanding hai, koi ek aspect janta hai ya koi ek idea hai us topic ke hawale se. Third hamare paas hai multi structure, means ki the student has a basic understanding of multiple aspects or ideas related to the topic. Means ki aap ye kahe ki student can describe, student can calculate, student can list and he can combine things. ठीक है कि basic उस topic के बारे में एक basic उसकी understanding होती है उसमें. Fourth आपके पास है rational. At this level student can make connections between different aspects or ideas related to the topic. Means कि आप ये कहें कि वो explain कर सकता है, वो solve कर सकता है, वो किसी topic को analyze कर सकता है या he can relate. Fifth is extended abstract. The student has a deep and comprehensive understanding of the topic and can apply it in new and unfamiliar context. Means ki ye jo highest level hai, theek hai, extended abstract, isme student means ki uski deep understanding hoti hai us topic ke hawale se, comprehensive understanding hoti hai. Means ki usme ye create kar sakta hai, usme predict karta hai us topic ke hawale se, he can reflect, वो इमेजिन कर सकता है, कैन एवेलुएट इवन और जनरलाइज कर सकता है. तो दिस इज द हाईएस्ट लेवल ऑफ सोलो टैक्सोनॉमी. अब हम बात करते हैं कि सोलो टैक्सोनॉमी इंपॉर्टेंट क्यों है. फर्स्टली सोलो टैक्सोनॉमी प्रोवाइड्स अ क्लियर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द लेवल ऑफ नॉलेज एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ स्टूडेंट इन अ पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट. सो सोलो टैक्सोनॉमी हेल्प्स टू आइडेंटिफाई द स्टूडेंट स्ट्रेंथ्स एंड वीकनेसेस, which is important for educators to provide the necessary support. Secondly, solo taxonomy help to set clear goals for students by identifying the level of understanding of the student. The educator can set achievable goals for students, which can motivate them to learn and excel. Thirdly, solo taxonomy helps to encourage critical thinking. This is very important. By identifying the level of understanding, the educator can create learning activities that encourage students to think critically, analyze and apply their knowledge to new situations. Finally, solo taxonomy helps in evaluation. You can say it's provide a clear framework for evaluating this understanding of student. which is important for educators to assess the effectiveness of their teaching strategies. Now we will talk about the practical application of the solo taxonomy. Means ki solo taxonomy ki practical application kya hai. The solo taxonomy has many practical application in teaching and learning. One of the most common use of the solo taxonomy is in lesson planning. So teacher can use the model to plan activities that will help student progress from one level to the next level. So another practical application is that the solo taxonomy is in assessment. Teacher can use the model to assess students' learning outcomes and provide appropriate feedback. It can also be used as a diagnostic tool to identify areas where students need additional support. So, solo taxonomy is an important framework for understanding and evaluating learning outcomes. So, it's helped to set goals, clear goals, identify strengths and weaknesses, encourage critical thinking and evaluate the effectiveness of teaching strategies. And simple, you can say solo taxonomy is a useful model for teacher to assess and improve students' learning outcomes, and it provides clear framework for understanding the different level of understanding of students and encourage students to take responsibility for their own learning. By using solo taxonomy in lesson planning and assessment, teacher can ensure that students are making progress and achieving their learning goals. It's all about the solo taxonomy. Aur abhi hum kuch MCQs discuss karenge solo taxonomy ke hawale se. Our first question is, pehla question hai. Solo taxonomy was presented by, you have four options. Which one is right? Right option is C, Biggs and Collis. Second question hai, what does the solo taxonomy stands for? Solo taxonomy stands for structure of observed learning outcome. B is the right answer. How many levels are there in solo taxonomy? Abhi humne baat ki kitne levels hain. To aapke paas hai 5 levels. Kaun-kaun se? Pre-structure level, unistructure level, multi-structure level, rational or extended abstract. So solo taxonomy ke 5 levels hain. Next question is, which of the following is the lowest level in the solo taxonomy? So lowest jo level hai wo kaun sa hai? Lowest level aapke paas hai pre-structure. At which level of solo taxonomy can a student apply their understanding new and unfamiliar context? Which one is right? The right answer is extended abstract. Kyunki ye highest level hai jisme bacche ki comprehensive jo hai understanding hoti hai. With reference to solo taxonomy, one aspect of task is understood in unistructure, multi, rational or extended abstract. So the right answer is unistructure. Uni jo structure hai usme ek aspect ke bare mein bacche ko pata hota hai. Two or more aspects are understood in unistructure, multi, rational or extended. So the right answer is multi-structure. Multi-structure jo level hai isme 2 ya usse zyada jo aspects ke bare mein bacche ko pata hoti hai. Next, what is the purpose of solo taxonomy? Solo taxonomy ka kya main purpose hai? To assess a student's level of understanding of topic, to assign grades to students, to evaluate a teacher performance, to create a ranking of students. So the right answer is to assess a student's level of understanding of topic. Thank you for listening, and I hope you found this lecture informative. If you have any question, write in the comment box. Thank you so much.